elicits dueling border visits. Both former President Trump and President Biden visited the southern border this week, although only one of them remembers the Alamo.
Yeah. Nice.
Trump was in Eagle Pass criticizing the president's lax immigration policies, calling the situation Joe Biden's invasion. Meanwhile, old Joe went to Brownsville blaming Republicans for blocking immigration legislation. But is Biden really serious about the border? Apparently not, because the White House just made up a sweet new-sounding euphemism for illegal aliens. Illegals are now referred to as newcomers, according to this official White House fact sheet. The ridiculous rebrand is rightfully being roasted online for its shameless attempt to destigmatize a criminal act. It's like when Greg calls exposing himself on the sidewalk enhanced interrogation techniques. Okay, newcomers, Kat, this is a new thing. I wonder why they are pulling this out now. Why go to the border and then try, you know, to try to sound like a tough guy and then come out with this newcomers thing?
Well, that's just it, right? Somebody missed the memo. Yeah. Somebody was writing that based on Joe Biden 2020 and not Joe Biden now, not getting the memo that he was supposed to be a tough guy on immigration now.
Yeah.
I think it's so much of that. It's all politics, right? Which is why I can't stand when politicians accuse each other of playing politics. Like, but that was what Biden, that's all he really said is, well, I'd love to fix this, but the Republicans won't let us. They blocked that deal. It's like, well, if it was really that important, then the deal would have just been about immigration and the border, for example, and not funded all these various foreign wars and other things. So
yeah.
it's all politics. I think somebody just kind of missed the memo that we weren't doing it that way anymore.
What good is it to go down to that border when doesn't everyone know the narrative at this point, Tyrus, that they basically had the border open. We know what they're doing. They're shipping people all around the country.
Right.
They're calling them newcomers. What good is... It's almost bad for him to go down the border. It looks bad.
It's bad if you're not on their side of things. Like, what Kat just said was too brilliant for them. Like, they're literally saying, split the diff. Like, we're going to look tough in front of the border, but we don't want to upset our progressives, so we'll go down there and look tough and call them newcomers, but we'll do it tough. So everybody will be happy.
Yeah.
And Kat gave them an out to even the way to do it, like say, oh, it's an old school thing. No, no, that's what he went to do. You're telling a guy who can't remember one foot goes in front of the other to split the diff, which means you have to know two things and make us convinced it's one. So that's what he was doing. And he did it horribly because he can't anymore. So when he goes to these places, they're just at this point, because they can't say, we are good with this situation. Our side of the street, the Democrats, we are fine. We call them newcomers. We have no problems with open borders. We are fine with this. That's why we got rid of all the executive orders, because I could do it myself if I wanted to.
Yeah.
I don't want to. I stopped them for a reason. This is how we look at our version of America. And hashtag newcomers, you should remember that and vote accordingly, America, period. You don't need Joe Biden's speech from Joe Biden to know where he stands. His actions, if you'd have to be blind not to see it. And if you are blind, I'm sorry. But you can see it.
And everybody's seeing it, Todd.
It's simple.
They're seeing it in the cities. We're seeing blue cities. People see this influx coming in. Even people who kind of sympathize with Biden's border policies, now they realize, like, what are we going to do? We're kind of in up to our neck. And at some point, they can't turn off the spigot because they've already said the borders are open.
Right. And I think Tyrus really nailed the point of this is a fundamental problem within this White House. This language of newcomers popping out, no matter what Joe Biden does, trying to look tough, it's all an act, because fundamentally, this is their vision, to use Tyrus's phrase, of what America is. What upsets me most about that, it's almost like they are treating these illegal migrants as freshmen at orientation. They call them newcomers.
Great point. Yep.
They give them their ID, their food card, their dorm, and much like how they're treating student loans, the American taxpayers are on the hook for it. There's a common college migrant tie here. And that is a huge problem, not only for Joe Biden in the election, because the cities are starting to realize, hey, we're getting screwed here. We put this guy in office. We thought we were going to get a lot of good handouts, and our budgets are getting decimated by these illegals. But it's a fundamental problem for America, because this is not how our system works. We help people when they're in need, but it's temporary. It's not permanent. And what we're doing for these illegal migrants, who aren't citizens, by the way, we need to make that point, is hurting our citizens. And there's no end in sight to it, Tom. That's the issue. This is a, go back to the college analogy, and I'll leave it there.
I love your college analogy.
This is, you go to college for 4, maybe 5 years, these migrants are going to be on the dole permanently, and that's a huge issue. I understand when somebody comes here legally, they may get some assistance right off the bat, but the goal is to get them in the system, working, being productive members. We've seen so many TikTok videos of these migrants saying, hey, I'm here, I'm on the dole for life.
They love
that's it. That's a problem.
That's a problem, Mackie. What are we going to do about it? That's right.
Tom, I hate that college analogy. at my orientation, my roommate's dad tried to introduce me to co-eds. It's so embarrassing, you know? I can get rejected on my own. Well, I'll say this. The left is great at euphemisms, like it's a border bill that gives discretionary power to the Homeland Security chief that we're trying to impeach right now for not doing his job. It's the same thing I do on first dates. You know, you don't want them to know about the past. You only want them to know about the good things you're doing now, except unlike President Biden, I can hold in my farts.
That's right. Okay, up next, he used football jargon after his client's plea bargain.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.